Allah says in the Quran in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 79. فَوَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ يَخْتُبُونَ الْكِتَابِ بَيْدِهِمْ ثُمَّ يَقُلُونَ هَذَا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ لِيَشْتَرُوا بِهِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا فَوَيْلٌ لَهُمْ مِمَّا كَتَبَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَيْلٌ مِمَّا يَكْسِبُونَ. That woe to those who write the book with their own hands and then say this is from Allah, to traffic with it for a miserable price. Woe to those for what they earn, woe to those for what they write. So here it's mentioned in the Quran that people write the scripture with their own hands and then say this is from Allah. So by the passage of time, all the scriptures that came before the Quran, they have been changed. And since they were not the last and final revelation, Almighty God did not think it fit to be preserved, because those were the previous revelations. But in spite of this corruption, in spite of the manipulation, in spite of the change, yet in the remnants of all the major world religions, in the scriptures, you will find the mention of monotheism, the oneness of Almighty God, that He has got no images, He is not begotten, He is one and only, there is nothing like Him. So if you believe in a concept of God, it should be according to your scriptures. There are some religions which are agnostic. You may not call them religions, like Buddhism. They don't comment on God. They are silent as far as God is concerned. And many ethical systems which I mentioned earlier, like Confucianism, Taoism, they are more of ethical systems than having a concept of God. And as far as the people who are atheists, like Jainism, etc., to those who are agnostic and atheist, they can refer to my video cassette, Is the Quran God's Word? And I gave that earlier also, as well as recently in Bombay a couple of months back, on the 24th of November, on the second day of the peace exhibition in Bombay, The Solution to Humanity, Is the Quran God's Word? If they see this cassette or the talk, inshallah, if the human being is unbiased, with the help of the Quran, I've proved the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As far as Islam is concerned, Islam does not merely believe in monotheism. Islam believes in Tawheed. Tawheed means unification. It means asserting oneness. It comes from the root word wahada, means to unite, to unify, it means to consolidate. Islam does not merely believe in believing in one God. It believes in Tawheed. And there are three categories of Tawheed. Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, Tawheed al-Asma wa Sifat, and Tawheed al-Ibadah. In the first category of Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, it means maintaining the unity of Rabb, unity of Lordship. Tawheed al-Rububiyyah is derived from the Arabic word Rabb, meaning Lord, Sustainer, Cherisher, meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator, the cherisher, the sustainer of everything in the universe. Everything is dependent on Him and He is independent of anything and everything. Maintaining the unity of Lordship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's called as Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. The second category is Tawheed al-Asma wa Sifat, maintaining the unity of the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is further divided into 5 subcategories. Number 1 is, whatever name you give to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it should be the name that He Himself has given Him. You give your own name to subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot say that Allah is Al-Ghadib, the angry one. The Quran does say He gets angry, but that's not one of the names Allah has given Himself or the messenger has given to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number 2, when you describe the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you describe it according to how Allah has described Himself or the messenger has described Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can't give your own description. And whatever the meaning is, you have to take it. You can't give your own description, allegorical meanings to the description of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The third is, you cannot give the qualities of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Allah Himself. You can't say that Allah forgets, knows billah. That is the quality of His creation. You cannot say Allah makes a mistake, like some of the scriptures say that God made a mistake, knows billah. These are the qualities of His creation. Number 4, you cannot give the attributes and qualities of Allah to any of His creation. You can't say, I know a person who's immortal, who's eternal. These are the qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the 5th category is, that you cannot give the name of Allah to any of his creation. If you have to give, you have to add abd to it. For example, you cannot say that he is Ar-Rahim. You can say Abdur-Rahim, the servant of the most merciful. And you cannot add anything to abd except Allah. Anything else besides Allah, you can't say Abdur-Rasul. He is the servant of Rasul. This is not permitted. It breaks the second category of Tawhid al-Asma wa Sifat. And the third category is Tawhid al-Ibadah, maintaining the unity of worship. Ibadah comes from the Arabic root word abd, which means to serve, meaning a slave, meaning a servant, servitude. We have to maintain the unity of worshipping Allah alone and no one else. Tawhid al-Ibadah means maintaining the unity of worshipping Allah alone and no one else. If you follow the first two categories, that Tawhid al-Rububiyah, saying Allah, He is a Rabb, He is a sustainer, creator, also agreeing with Tawhid al-Asma wa Sifat, giving Him good names and attributes, creator, etc. But if you worship somebody else besides Allah, then too you're breaking Tawhid. And there are several such examples in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, in Surah Yunus, chapter number 10, verse number 31, refers to the pagans of Makkah, refers to the mushriks, and he says that when you ask them that who is the one who sustains the things in the heavens and the earth, who has the power to hear and see, who has the power to give life to the dead and dead to the life, who has power to regulate all the affairs, they will say Allah. Then why don't you show piety to him? That means Allah is referring to these pagan Arabs in Makkah. He is agreeing that they believe in Allah, they called him Allah, they gave him good attributes, good names. Tawhid al-Rububiyah was there, Tawhid al-Asma wa Sifat was there, but they worshipped things other than Allah. And the similar example is given in Surah Zukhruf, chapter number 43, verse number 87, that when you ask these mushriks that who is the one who gave life to you, they will say Allah. Then why do you join partners with him? So here we realize that only following the first two categories is not sufficient. Following all three categories of Tawheed simultaneously is important. If you break any one of the categories of Tawheed, it's called as Shirk. Shirk in Islam is the biggest sin. Shirk in Arabic means associating partners. In the Islamic terminology, it means associating partners with Allah. It is the biggest sin. If you break any one of the three categories of Tawheed, you're doing shirk. It is the biggest sin in Islam. And Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 48, Allah forgiveth not that you associate partners with him. Anything else, if he pleases, he may forgive. But anyone who associate partners with him has done the most grievous, heinous sin. The same message is repeated in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 116. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not forgive the sin of joining gods with him. Anything else, if he pleases, he may forgive. But anyone who has joined gods with Allah, he has strayed away too far. So according to the Quran, the sin which Allah will never forgive is shirk.